that where the invisible is seen, the uncreated is created. From the Vision of God by Nicholas of Cusa, 1401 to 1464. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Crown of my joy and happiness, thou hast appeared unto me sometimes as invisible from every creature, because thou art a God, secret and hidden, and infinite is incomprehensible by any manner of comprehension. Then thou appearest to me as visible to all things, for everything is so far forth as thou seest it, and that could not be in act, except it did see thee, for vision gives being, because it is thy essence. So thou, my God, art visible, and invisible thou art, invisible as thou art, and thou art visible as the creature is, which so far forth is as it sees thee, by everything that sees, in everything that may be seen, and in every act of seeing art thou seen, which art invisible and absolute, and free from all such things, and infinitely superexalted. Therefore, O Lord, I must leap over the wall of invisible vision where thou art found, and the wall is all things, and nothing both together, and thou which meetest or appearest to us as though thou wert all things, and nothing at all both together, dwelleth within that high wall, which no wit can by its own power ever be able to climb. Sometimes thou appearest unto me, so that I imagine thou seest all things in thyself, like a living glass, in which all things shine. And because thy seeing is thy knowing, then it comes into my mind that thou dost not see also things in thyself as in a living glass, for then thy knowledge shouldest arise from the things. Sometimes thou presentest thyself to me that thou seest all things in thyself as power or virtue by looking upon itself as the power or possibility of the seed of a tree. If it should look into and behold itself, would in itself see the tree in power, because the virtue of the seed is potentially the tree. And then again, me thinkest that thou dost not see thyself and all things in thyself as power or possibility. For to see a tree in the power of the virtue differs from that vision by which the tree is seen in act. And then I find how thy infinite virtue or power is beyond all specular and seminal virtue, and beyond the coincidence, radiation, or reflection of the cause, and also the thing caused, and that that absolute virtue is absolute vision, which is perfection itself, above all manner of seeing. For all the manners which explain the perfection of seeing are without any manners, thy vision, which is thy essence, O my God. But suffer, most merciful Lord, that I, thy wild creature, may yet speak unto thee. If thy seeing be thy creating, and thou seest nothing but thyself art the object of thyself, for thou art both the thing seen and the things seen, and the act of seeing, how then dost thou create other things from thee? For thou seest to create thyself as thou seest thyself. But thou comfortest me, O life of my spirit, for although I meet with the wall of absurdity, which is of the coincidence of creating and being created, as though it were impossible that creating and being created should coincide, for to admit this seemest to be as if thou should affirm that a thing is before it is, for when it creates it is, and because it is created it is not, yet it hinders not. For thy creating is thy being, neither is it any other thing at once to create and to be created, than to communicate thy being unto all things, that thou mayest be all things in all things, and yet remain absolute from all things. For to call to being things that are not is to communicate being to nothing. So to call is to create, to communicate is to be created. And beyond this coincidence of creating and being created, art thou God absolute and innate, neither creating nor impossibility of being created, although they are all that they are, because thou art. O thou heights of riches, how incomprehensible thou art! As long as I conceive a creator creating, I am yet on this side the wall of paradise. So as long as I conceive a creator in possibility of being created, I have not entered, but am in the wall. But when I see thee as absolute infinite, whereunto neither the name of a creator creating, nor of a creator in possibility of being created can agree, then I begin to see thee revealedly, and to enter into the garden of delights. Because thou art no such thing as can be said or conceived, but infinitely and absolutely superexalted above all such things. Thou art not therefore only a creator, but infinitely more than a creator, though without thee nothing is done or can be done. To thee be praise and glory forever and ever. Amen. End of That Where the Invisible is Seen, the Uncreated is Created, from The Vision of God, by Nicholas of Cusa, 1401 to 1464.